you're in for a real treat today. And I met Van-Anh through Ron and Lynn Hare about 4 years ago, was it? About 5 years ago? My brother, who's a hockey celebrity, called me and said that somebody, I don't know whether it was you or Jason or somehow, they connected and said that there was this piano player coming, and they knew I was musical. They'd seen my article in the paper about my rhythm master. So I felt like I won the lottery, because I got invited to a wine and pairing where I met and was privileged to hear Van-Anh in person for the first time. That's where I first met Ron and Lynn. And yeah, then Ron and Lynn moved in here, and I will introduce Ron to tell you.
Welcome everybody. So great to see a good turnout, and just wanting a little bit of background. Approximately, we were trying to figure it out, 10 or 12 years ago, we were on a cruise somewhere, I think South America, and we ran into Van-Anh, and coincidences happened after one another. Anyways, we became very good friends. We've been extremely good friends. She calls us her Canadian grandparents. And we are the lucky ones. Van-Anh has had the opportunity and put in the work. She's played on many, many finest stages all around the world. She started her piano career at the age of 14 months. At the ripe old age of 6, she gave her first performance at the iconic Sydney Opera House.
Wow.
You guys are in for a real treat. And so we're so happy to have the acquaintance of such a young and beautiful lady. And trust me, she's just as beautiful on the inside as she is on the outside. So, Van-Anh.
Thank you.
It's such an honor to be here. It's of course it's been like several, probably 3 years since I've been back in Osoyoos to see Ron and Lynn. We had a pandemic in the middle of all of it, so it stopped me from coming back from Australia, back over here. But I love being back here, and I always like to start my concerts off with a little bit of Chopin, because he is a composer who dedicated pretty much his entire life writing music only for the piano, which is pretty rare. He only lived for a very short time of about 38 years, but he left us with so many incredible pieces, and he really explored what the piano was able to give us with these 88 keys. So I'm going to play one more piece by Chopin before we move on to a couple of other things. This one is called the Fantasy Impromptu, and it has two really beautiful themes. And I think it represents his personalities really well. It's got the sort of, like the nocturne that you just heard, the more beautiful, reflective side of his writing. And then there's the other side, which is much more energetic and virtuosic, and it shows all the flair of the piano. So I hope you enjoy the Fantasy Impromptu. Thank you.
Thank you. Impressionist period. I'm going to play one piece by Debussy, and then we'll kind of mix it up with a couple of different genres after this. But this is definitely one of the favorites. I'm sure you all will recognize it. It's written inspired by the moon, and it's probably the most well-known piece by Debussy. This is Clair de Lune.
Thank you.
two younger siblings who also play the piano, so music was always around the house. But at some point, I definitely felt like I wanted to branch out and play other music other than classical music. And I came across a quote by Picasso, which I really related to. The quote said that, "Learn the rules like a pro so you can break them as an artist." And I love this because I think as musicians, we strive for perfection and we try to, you know, get all the right notes and be more accurate and try to give our best performance. But I think what makes the performance is really trying to be able to give your personality, inject your personality into your performance, into your piece. So this next work is a piece, again, that I think you all will recognize. It goes by two different titles. It's the Alla Turca, it's by Mozart. It's the Alla Turca, or the Turkish March, but it's done with a little bit of a twist. And I think the easiest way to explain this is just imagine if Mozart was born in New Orleans. This is what it would sound like.
Disney. So last year I had the opportunity of rearranging a lot of these Disney classics, but just for piano. And that's part of what I love doing, is like sharing the love of piano, but in different styles and different genres, and making sure that it still stays alive. So I'm going to play two Disney songs, I think. The first is the theme from Beauty and the Beast, And then the second is, it will be from Aladdin, A Whole New World, which I hope you all will enjoy.
Thank you.
fun. So my second last piece for today, we're gonna go to Argentina. And we're gonna play one of my favorite dance genres, which is the tango. And Piazzolla is a composer who, he really revolutionized the style of tango writing. He threw a lot of surprises in there. It's not your traditional tango style of writing. And this is probably his most well-known tango piece called the Lieber Tango, which it's got accordion and violins and a couple of other instruments, but we'll do the piano solo version today. So this is his Lieber Tango.
Thank you.
because...
Oh, it's very special.
When I came here, oh my gosh, I don't know what year it was.
That was when I first saw you, because
yeah.
it had just been released.
That's right, it had
yeah.
just been released, and the day I played here
yes.
in the theater, it ended up charting in the Canadian charts and the US charts after the concert. We found out on the charts that it had been charting. But also, there was a piano out by, because it's by the lake, the piano. There was like a piano that anyone could play on, and so we did a little impromptu performance outside, which was super fun as well. So that piece is always connected to Osoyoos for me, forever. So yeah, we can do Children as the final piece.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And we would like, Van-Anh does these awesome candlelight concerts too, where she literally has, I don't know, thousands of candles. Oh my goodness, we couldn't provide that. But it reminds us of what a light she is in bringing and sharing her talent.
It's my pleasure.
So thankful. So we shine our lights. We thank Dron and Lynn that they've come here and joined our community. Yes. Thank you. Ron and Lynn, come up here and say a special thank you to you also.
Yeah, that's okay. I'll take it.
3D glasses. Well, we're going to be able to play this for you upstairs on your TV, and we'll be able to enjoy more of Van-Anh with us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.